Something happened which in a roundabout way was enlightening. It was a tiny incident in itself, but it gave me a better glimpse than I had had before of the real nature. I remember that it was a cloudy, stuffy morning at the beginning of the rains. We began questioning the people as to where the elephant had gone, and as usual failed to get any definite information. Some more women followed, clicking their tongues and exclaiming, evidently there was something that your children ought not to have seen. They had not shown much interest in the elephant when he was merely ravaging their homes, but it was different now that he was going to be shot. It was a bit of fun to them. Besides, they wanted the meat. It made me vaguely uneasy. They were watching me as they would watch a conjurer about to perform a trick. But in reality, I was only an absurd puppet pushed to and from by the will of those. At that age, I was not squeamish about killing animals, but I had never shot an elephant and never wanted to. Somehow, it always seems worse to kill a large animal. Besides, there was the beast's owner to be considered. It is a serious matter to shoot a working elephant. It is comparable to destroying a huge and costly piece of machinery. Alive, the elephant was worth at least 100 pounds. Dead, he would only be worth the value of his tusks, 5 pounds possibly. But I had got to act quickly. In that instant, in too short a time, one would have thought, even for the bullet to get there, a mysterious, terrible change had come over the elephant. He neither stirred nor fell, but every line of his body had altered. He looked suddenly stricken, shrunken, immensely old, as though the frightful impact of the bullet had paralyzed him without knocking him down. A story always sounds clear enough at a distance, but the nearer you get to the scene of events, the vaguer it becomes. Some of the people said that the elephant had gone in one direction. Some said that he had gone in another. Some professed not even to have heard of any elephant. I had almost made up my mind that the whole story was a pack of lies. It was obvious that the elephant would never rise again, but he was not dead. He was breathing very rhythmically with long, rattling gasps.